what if it could be proven and you could discover that we are all the offspring of God, and that all of us in our eternal spirits would have the same mind that was manifested in the Son of God when he came in his mode of a human being, had the same mind and same Father, same God. If we would listen to him, could regain that sonship that was not manifested because of the fall of a couple, Adam and Eve, listening to the lie of Lucifer, who started this whole thing of iniquity in heaven. Now, getting past any ideas of this with groups like Universalists, Inclusionists, Gnostic teaching, or New Age teaching, that's nothing more than distortion of a one-time known truth hidden in the mind of God to be manifested in the fullness of time. And that reason being, if this mystery ever was revealed, it would prove what God has said concerning this fallen mind. It would be treacherous and distort the fact of our being the offspring of God, and would start debates, divisions. It was Apostle Paul who discovered this and shared this truth, and before the ink dried on his parchments, that truth was already being distorted. So what if this truth was discovered? What would happen? Well, you don't need to ask the question because you've seen what's happened. The mystery has been revealed and it's being distorted, covered over. Because what the devil didn't know, now he knows. He doesn't want anyone else to find his truth out. He'll lead you to believe anything but what God has tried to tell you through his Son, who manifests an eternal fact, declaring that it was finished, that anything that cut us off from God was solved prior to it even occurring, to the Son offering his life before the foundations of this world. If the need would arise, the Son would come and restore the sons of God back to their sonship and correct the greatest injustice. This is something I repeat over and over again because it's the truth. He solved the greatest injustice ever to be served upon humanity. That being born to the loins of Adam and his fall, you were placed under the wrath of God. Which would have been an injustice. It comes out what's called justification. God took this injustice and justified us as though we were never cut off from God, but were sons of God that never got revealed or manifested because of the fall of that one couple. And God corrected the injustice and offered the opportunity for you to discover this fact, that hidden under this mask of some particular race, culture, sexual, religious creed, or your opinion as male or female, is hidden this fact that you are a son of God. Whether you understand that or not depends upon you letting go of what you have conjured up according to your opinions, with your fallen rogue soul that fell. The human spirit never fell. He lies dormant, ready to be worked out at the surrendering of this rogue fallen soul. He came to save the soul, to renew that mind, after the mind that should have been expressed in the human spirit, this mind of Christ, the anointing of God, our Father, who would have expressed who we were and our purpose for coming to this materially created world and to express our sonship to a body that could have lived on this planet forever, have we not been cut off from this eternal fact. Death is introduced to get us back. The law was introduced to get us back. Death and the law. O grave, where is thy victory? O death, where is thy sting? The sting of death is sin, our acting independent from God. The strength of sin is the law. It reveals a rebellious soul trying to play like God, pretending to be sons of God, yet with a rogue soul cut off from the power and the mind of Christ, which contains all the wisdom of God, all that we express is the divisions that we see and not the unity of the Spirit that could have been. In order to preserve the union of spirit and a bond of peace, a peace that is said to transcend all ideas of peace, opinions and ideas, that unity would never be found in the flesh. You'll never get all the races, all this diversity, race, cultures, second religious creeds, opinions of gender, male, female, and all these other self-created genders we see today. You'll never find a unity of that. And any human effort to start a new creation by doing away with the cultures, with this canceling cultures today, doing away with the idea of use of male, female, and doing away with religion, and starting a whole new religion, a whole new idea of God, to which this Antichrist will introduce himself as God, and he'll change the laws and rules. And he'll decide to start a whole new creation, but his end product will be to the annihilation of all race, cultures, and creeds, and gender. Where God's trying to wean us from our fallen soul and our races, our cultures and creeds and gender, is trying to restore us back to who we already are.